It is very fitting for our final game of this grand final that we have a draft that really seems to just be comfort zone for both of these teams. You get the Lifesteal, the last pick up, the Alchemist is back up. Again, we've got Grimstroke combinations. It just feels like both teams are at least playing with what they like. But how does it play up against each other? Who has the advantage coming into game five?
I think it's going to come down to play, Toby, as you said. It's comfort. We have Ember Spirit. We have Grimstroke. They know how to win games with these heroes. We've seen them beat Alchemist twice up against Alliance in the lower bracket earlier today. But that wasn't the TNC Alchemist, which is still, I believe, undefeated in this tournament. And it's a tough test. But if you're GPK, young, new guy on the block, when it's game five, you want your best. And so far, his Ember Spirit, certainly that.
It really has been amazing. I just want to see just how well Gambit can invade the jungle to control the stacks. And not just the first time around, it's when it swings back the opposite direction. It's when you just see Armel move from the north to the south, like we've even seen Armel move into the opposite jungle. It's like, okay, well, this will all work for us. And they'll have a lot of survivability once he reaches that point. March back on this Undying, we've already seen how much his Soul Assumptions can do, but you got KP saves, both for others as well as himself. And not to mention just the fact that Bristleback, it can take a while before you get your Silver Edge. FNG, it's like he was trying to bait, he's going for the other one. This'll just end up being a 2-for-2 rune trade-off. Still a lot of damage into March, but he's stolen 16 strength already, so at 960 HP.
It's also March we're talking about.
Make it 20.
This is kind of his MO, right? Spam your mana, help your cores.
Walk to base, come back out again.
Uh-huh.
An easy reset for him. Shashlo is trying to grab that second wave. Tims will be the man in charge of stopping him. Ring of Basilius. Orana Rome gets to do that. Oh, the Grimstroke takes the lane against Gabby. I'm not quite certain how well this works, considering you've just gone level one Nasal Goo.
That was really cool. See what Shacklo just did? He taunted the creep wave, and it draws aggro on him all the way up on the high ground. So now he's going to be able to pull it all the way around the tower. Really cool maneuver. And Tims is like, oh, well, I can't do anything up here. Let me just go bottom with this Bassy. Look to try and pressure. And March actually swapping up to the top lane. Interesting. I guess they wanted him against the Kunkka. You don't want two melee against Lifestealer. It is often a trade you're not going to win. That arrow would land and maybe even kill FNG. But I think the matchup we want to focus on is the one our camera's on. GPK versus Armel.
Yep. How much Armel is able to really stay on top of this Ember Spirit? Ember's still walking around with the South. So is Armel, so you're already feeling like harassment-wise is going better. But when GPK gets so many denies,
it's really
that's
nice.
That's where you get the pressure. And like, it's the range ones too he's taking away from the Alchemist.
Ooh, he cancels the salve there, but he did have to blow an acid spray for it. 130 mana for about 110 gold.
It's not going to be in the position of the wave he wants it either. It's a small avenue. GPK just walks down the side.
Yep, now he's popped the flame guard. Easy peasy.
Now harass Armel out of the lane. It just goes back and forward both ways. As Armel can burn his salve if he wants to. Illusion Rune for the Ember. Still a little bit away from his bottle, so he can't utilize this totally yet. But a fun CS battle, but we know CS in the early game. It's okay for an Alchemist, but it's not the be-all, end-all. Bottom lane, KP. Dream is having a run towards him, then switches attack over towards Tims, who, as always, ready to utilize his leap to change the position up.
Yep. This will be a really cool game. Both lineups built around their mid players. Ember Spirit with two shields that can be placed on him to amplify his damage output and provide some disable. Alchemist with two healers behind him, a Bristleback to continue diving forwards with him, and a ton of minus armor represented by the lineup. Really cool concepts.
Josh Lowe's at it again. Yep. It's March's turn to try and do the denial.
Yep, this is what I was talking about. He just torrents the wave and starts pulling it around. And Undying, it's a great zoner, sure, but there's nothing you can really do to stop a Kunkka.
What makes it really cool, too, is the fact that Grimstroke is then able to get so much more out of the lane. Like, yep. Obviously, he's not getting as much from the creep wave, but he can play the range game against Gabby. Slow him down if you need to. If Gabby wants to charge him, you've got the Inkswell. So Gabby can't commit instantly onto a target.
Yep. This is really cool. Shackler's denying an entire wave with this double creep wave. In fact, he might even be able to get another one if he keeps spamming. In fact, he will, thanks to that aggro glyph from TNC.
They're doing it so Ember Spirit can't take this mid lane. It's Armel trying to get the upper hand. GPK is pretty low. He doesn't have a Flame Guard available. He's got a Slider Fist. Armel will need two punches to make this work. Think about coming into the town, but just denies the creep instead. It looks like GPK will go all the way back to base. Oh, will he? No, there's just a salve. It came out in the courier, so he doesn't have to leave.
Yep. Nothing going on thus far. 0-0. But this will not be the same as that second and fourth game where the teams just play passively. It's going to heat
up
soon.
I see one hand of Midas being prepped over on Dream. We just need another two. Yeah, Alchemist obviously will never do that. KP and Tim's doesn't feel like they can zone out this lifesteal. This is a good CS game for Dream. Shashlo, like, he's got a lot himself. Like, everyone seems like they're just getting what they want. The supports stay low on the CS, but everyone else gets everything. So I want to see the rotations. I want to see that next wave of vision. I want to see Lich not die, but it seems FNG, the issue, was pushed against him.
That's just a better lane. You can't really harass an Abaddon as the lifestealer. You end up trading, sure. It's not like you get forced out of lane, but Abaddon definitely one of the better heroes against him.
And when that kill happens, like, you see where Armel is. He's currently inside the jungle taking a very huge stack. This is so much for Armel. As long as he doesn't die, and he's not a healthy man, he'll have to burn the 5-minute shrine, which is now up. And that was when the battle for the runes was underway, but this miss call has to come out from GPK. Like, they have to understand that Armel is currently AWOL. And even marched. Yeah, Soul Rip up, Armel gets his life back. And Chemical Rage, six is on the board.
They're really happy with this. So much gold going into his pocket. This is the Alk strat, right? Look at the net worth.
3.5k now for him, 2.2k for the Ember. All of this comes from the stack.
The lane was even. It is no longer. And he even goes for that double bracer, a little bit of magic, there's just a ton of HP. I like this decision. You can expect Gambit to play aggressive, right? We've seen this time and time again. You double shield the Ember, he remnants forwards, GPK makes the play.
Give that man an ink swell as well. Whatever stuns you can get, whatever control and damage you have. And someone have to start killing somebody.
Somebody's gonna have to buy a Spirit Vessel on Radiant. I expect it'll probably be Shacklo on the offlane Kunkka. You need some method of slowing down Armel's regen, but
he's copying so much damage from FNG, but the shield's there from KP. Dreams come over now. Here comes Vampire, slow down KP. Doesn't have the borrow time available. In fact, the Inkswell and GPK rotates in nicely. The jump down from Tim's, that was his last leap. A Spirit up, then down again.
Oh no.
Look into the right trees. In fact, it's actually the left trees, not the right trees. Tim's starts his TP out. Anyone got enough damage? Yes, they do. GPK claims the kill, but making the rotation worth it. But yeah, I don't
know. Look at
Armel. I know where you're going.
Yeah. It's all good and well and dandy, but hey, you're killing your safe lane by your own tier two. It's space for Armel Alchemist.
And Undying's getting space in the mid lane.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Play the Jaws theme, man, because we've seen this how many times? Alchemist Dota 2. Armel just gonna farm these jungle stacks. Once again, March Dota, always there to ensure that his Alk.
Bottom lane, they're gonna go towards KP. They need an extra slow. And oh, they're gonna have one. Well, throw it out. Vampire trying to find the right line. First, he waits for the stun with the Frost Blast and the shields and everything else. They just go through a bad, but no, all of that work, and it's just a denial. Well played.
Oh, saved. Alchemist, still farming, have no fear. Nothing really changing.
They're going for Gristle back. Gristle's in a little too deep. GPK really trying to be influential in this game. Take out the side lanes. You'll have to work with Shashlo. Doesn't have Searing Chains available, but it won't matter. So Gabby, FNG will give the shields. GPK got to close the distance to make that really work. With the Frost Blast, Gabby gets slowed down. X mark ship. Torrent. Sorry.
Okay. You notice a pattern though, Toby? That's two times now you've watched the Ember Spirit rotate, but it's to kill heroes in side lanes at his own tier twos. These TNC players are intentionally playing hyper aggressive to draw space and just pressure away from Armel.
Yep.
He's now got another double stack. He's so efficient. Every time he farms around the minute mark, he's stacking at least one, oftentimes two camps. He's gonna have a relic complete in about 1.5 minutes.
Can they kite him? Can Gambit actually do that with their lineup? Do they have enough control when Alchemist has Radiance, when Alchemist has PKB?
That's a good question, Toby. I think it's about the timing, right? We've seen this Radiance become a BKBAC heart within another 7 or 8. That's the window where TNC look to just go end game. The one upside for Gambit, they don't have the catch. Or rather, TNC don't have the catch, Gambit do. We can see X, you've got 2 supports that can assist their Ember Spirit to go deep, and a Lifestealer who will be buying a Midas, but man, it's just always spooky. He's already doubled up by Armel. This guy farms incredibly quickly, and look, another stack, easy peasy.
And I don't think Shashlaw is gonna be happy with that at all. Kunkka dying to the Bristleback. That's like all that hard work that Ember does when he rotates to the side lanes to get these kills, to try and slow down at least the side laner so these cores aren't big. Now Bristleback, with that kill in the space he created, is the second highest net worth on the field. Obviously, he'll never be the number one when Alchemist is on the board.
Alchemist is so farmed, man.
Yeah.
He's so efficient. He's farming nearly the entire jungle, every single spawn. He's gonna have a Radiance up in at about 10:30, which is one of the faster timings for this tournament. I feel like I'm well watching.
Wait for the breach. That's when it gets spectacular. Like, even if you get your farm with a lifesteal on the bottom, like, he's about to finish up a hand of Midas. So Dream has some level of progression. We're gonna go again onto Gabby. Pick him up, throw him down, put the combination out, and they will burn through the Bristleback. Even a Spirit Committal to ensure the GPK gets the last hit, and they're all here for the 10-minute runes. But look at the Invis Undying with the Moonlight Shadow. He'll steal it from Lich. The Moonlight Shadow will wear off in a second. TP supports on the way from the Grimstroke, but someone needs to bring a bottom lane. Lifestealer has no way out this one. Leap forward, KP working together.
That was so sick. Tim's actually just camped him, hits him with an arrow. They recognize he's out of mana, and then Abaddon just right-clicks him. That's a huge kill. And that's a Radiance, by the way, en route to Armel. 10 minutes, 22 seconds in.
Delaying a hand of Midas while getting a Radiance over on your Ember, on your Alchemist. Ember Spirit's going deeper onto Gabby, onto the tier 1 tower. Vampire realizing, yeah, that tree's being cut.
And keep in mind,
very visible.
This is how Gambit was able to beat Alk against Alliance. It's about killing the other heroes, ignore the Alk, make the rest of his team suffer. But it wasn't on this farm, this fast.
They're having issues killing Gabby now.
Yep.
When you got this many heroes, you got 4 heroes up on the top lane. Chainfrost bounces out, but it gets lost in the creep wave, goes back over to Gabby. But even with the extra slowness, it's not enough. The Tombstone defensively gets dropped by Munch, very deep behind the tier 1 tower. But Gambit are just trying to get something on the map. But look where Armel is. He's out of the jungle. He's on the tier 1 tower, working with the catapult to get rid of that tower. And there's nothing Shashlaw can do. His X-Mark is now going to come off cooldown, but the tier 1 tower is lost. It was Gambit who was looking to take the property, but they lose out. In fact, Ember Spirit just uses Slide of Fist. Spirit will get him down into the river.
They're rolling, man.
They turn attention towards the Grimstroke. He has to kind of ink swell or do something here, but under the tower, he'll dodge the arrow. The shields are up from FNG. Now the ink swell is up, but it won't be able to trigger. It can't stay alive long enough. Bristleback, the silence will wear off. And GPK can't even do enough damage to kill off Timbs, who was diving into the tower. Gabby stays on it, and Shashlaw comes in. Gabby's got himself a double kill, but this is all, remember, distraction. If he gets 2 kills and dies, it's still worthwhile. March is helping him out, giving him some more life, but he cannot tank through the ship. And March, for all that support he was trying to give, he doesn't have the life to back it up.
It's all just a distraction though, Toby. They could have backed out, but they're like, no, we're gonna die, we're gonna kill this Lich. Yeah, we lose 2. But as you said, it's all space. And it's a difference in theory for these teams. TNC confident to give the keys to the game to Armel, trusting in the Alk, also going for that early blink, not the BKB, trying to make a play because he's just so damn far ahead. You can turn this advantage even to an even further one if you find a kill on Dream.
It's dangerous though, like without having that immunity, Gambit still have a chance to lock you down and try and kill you off.
But they're ignoring him. The strategy is to try and slow down his teammates. They're playing around the side lanes, but who cares about that? Here we go.
See your reaction time. Concoction, blink forward, Rage will come up, and then a quick TP away, so the arrow will be wasted too. But you take the tier 1 tower on bottom lane by forcing the TP out. But that's the first blink reveal. TNC would have been happier to get a kill from this, but you're still okay. Armel is farming and is a beast. His BKB is now a Mithril Hammer and Recipe away, thanks to the 1,000 gold he claimed in the last 1 minute. This is Dota.
Mm-hmm. That entire net worth lead is all the Alchemist.
Gambit are coming to fight. They're headed to the bottom lane. They have one ready and observe ward that sees where Tim's is. Wouldn't be a bad kill. It won't be the greatest kill they ever want, but a quick X mark. Able to claim it, Moonlight Shadow, throws a quick arrow, won't be able to hit on anybody, they're just pulling back into the combination. Dust was brought along, so there's no hiding inside the Moonlight Shadow.
Does that kill really matter is the question, though, Toby.
Well, if Tims could actually global laugh that, then the answer would be no.
Yep.
It would be full on mockery.
A lot of teams talk about it, but when it comes to these critical games, right, long day for Gambit. Approaching 11 p.m. local here. Game 5 and TNC, their draft's all about ease of execution, right? Play around the Alchemist, Armel will carry us. Gambit, they're going to have to keep out playing. And in the two games they won, that's exactly what they did. But they're going to have to keep this kill score advantage. Find a kill on Alk before his BKB if you can, but it's just so tough. And more importantly, they don't have any towers, Toby. That's how you beat these fast farming map control based cores like Tinker, like Meepo, like Alk. You don't have any. There's no way for you to cross the river, get aggressive into the enemy jungle. Armel is doing whatever he wants. You scan him out. So what? What are you going to do?
I know where he is at least, but there's only so many smokes you can use to go for a chase. They have one on the Grimstroke, but he spent most of his time, Vampire, just trying to defend the mid lane. Like, he's kept the push going. They're finding experience, and that's a nice thing. X marks the spot. We're going to put Gabby to the test in the mid lane. Actually, no, we're not going to do anything of the sort. GPK as well as KP, there's no kill potential there. But when you see Gambit start next mark spot with two supports behind and they still don't go for it, now we have another shit. There's the whole thing together, combining with the Chain Frost and the extra stance that you get in front of him. The Torrent is up in the air, but March will arrive with an extra Sol Rip. They'll get the life back, arrow flies forward. No one wants to catch that.
Three bounty runes going the way of TNC. This is all good for you. And you keep trying to kill Bristleback, Toby.
God, it's a 15-minute BKB with the blink of the Radiance.
It didn't even slow him down. He's 14K. Dream is at 6.4.
It is 990 gold per minute on this Alchemist. It is ridiculous. And the Tier 1 tower is what Gambit's trying to pressure. But even if they claim this, it still won't be huge. The arrow flies forward. Tim's just taking care of the catapult, so the pressure into the tower is now gone. And your lifestealer can't outfarm this. He's trying to build into an armlet. And maybe then Gambit can do something, but they need a delivery system, the Ember, as well as the lifestealer. Can't he, like, infest, pop, destroy someone, and keep going and going?
You can't even lock him down properly. He's got an Abaddon behind him. You shield off any stun, pop BKB. Yeah, you're not touching this guy anymore. The physical damage is not there. You're going to need to buy a lot more time with your Gambit.
But you need to do, like, what? Time doesn't help you against an Alchemist game.
No, it doesn't, Toe. Well,
like, even if you run this game to, like, 90 minutes, it still feels like TNC is going to be ahead.
If it keeps like this, it will. I mean, it's just the levels as well. Yeah, sure, Gabby's died three times, but he's still got 126 CS, and he's very tanky.
Here we go, Alchemist again looking for a blink concoction. Vampire's the target, makes a break for the tree line. Conker gonna give both ship and torrent. Alchemist will be sent up. Armel would love to keep fighting.
83 health regen, Toby. It's not.
It ain't happening.
It's not real.
you need Ancient Apparition. You need something. You need to not have this fourth picked against you in game 5 of the grand final.
Now you just link up, go join your Alchemist, or rather your Abaddon.
KP's gonna try and silence Dream, so the Blink Concoction from Armel is able to connect,
close.
But no, the timing a little bit off, Armel ends up stunning himself. And you look towards the mid, here we go onto Gabby, March is nearby once again, Tombstone over on the hill, they battle underneath their own Observer Ward, Sinister Gaze Anthony to try and keep this Bristle back under control, but you've got through half of his life, and Armel's ready to blink in for another Concoction. You can Soul Bind them together, damage is big, combining with a double Chain Frost, the Soul Bind now moving over towards Armel, but you've only killed a one-for-one trade-off. The Torrent's onto KP, but he's got borrowed time. This battle won't continue in favor of Gambit when the arrow connects, and down goes Conker for 44 seconds.
Casual 10K gold lead at 17 minutes. Nothing to see here. It doesn't feel that way, but...
They go for Roshan now. You got 3 points needs with Gu. You got enough armor removal. Roshan's at negative 7. Negative 14. Just keeps increasing. And Gambit, how do you even fight this? Without the Conker ship, you don't really have that big team fight. Grimstroke can have a look in by throwing out that Stroke of Fate, so he can at least have a bit of a squiz. And the Roshan dying, Ember Spirit, the Slider Fist comes in, good Searing Chain Spirit, ready to jump forward, and goes in, but FNG, who gets the even smaller, goes in the hands of Armel. Alchemist looking to blink himself out and get himself a Concoction Stun, doesn't see anyone in range, he won't stun himself, the BKB will absorb it, but FNG trapped in the tree lines, a quick slow from Vampire, trying to create a little bit of extra space, and the silence onto Gabby, that doesn't save FNG's life. The boat just creates a little bit of extra space, but Gabby feels so strong, approaching Tier 3 towers. still looking to fight, but Lifestealer, he's taking the tier 1 tower on top. They just don't want this. Mid is trying to delay. Sharshlow is going to be careful. Hexmark is how he does so.
Don't know if it matters what you want, Toby. TNC, huge lead. Another tower falls. Now up 4-1 in the objective game.
The two heroes who are not there, they're looking for their critical items. The BKB for the Ember, he's farming the Dire Jungle. Yep. You've got Dream on top, looking to get into that Desolator. Maybe if they rip away the armor of the Alchemist, they have a chance to get through him. But once he has AC, that chance is gone.
And Armel, he's done it again, where he goes for this efficiency item instead of rushing those big timing items in the AC Heart. This time, he knew he had to TP base, so he buys bots. Slows down that progression, but it increases his efficiency.
Lifestealer, get the hell out of there. X marks the spot, looking to pull KP back into a Torrent, create a little bit of extra space. Lifestealer just saw like 6 range creeps on bottom and wanted to farm it because the rest of his team came out, had the confidence. FNG, TP's away to safety. They don't have the stun available. And Lifestealer, okay. Underneath its own Obs and Sentry near the Shrine. More TP supports coming in the form of GPK. They're looking for a target. Gabby seems to be it, but Gabby can't be it. They don't have the damage for him. And Kunk is in the back lines, can throw down the ship, but Lifestealer is just getting the crap beaten out of him. The shields are up. Now the Chain Frost will start to bounce around. The damage, it already comes too late. Lifestealer is dead, and Alchemist under BKB and Aegis, you know he's going to dive this. Looking for the stun, he gets onto the Grimstroke, it gets dumped back in under the almost the tier 4 towers. Gabby is going. TNC, they want to win in style. Remember, you haven't taken all the tier 2s yet. You're almost at the fountain. Gambit have no buybacks available. Gabby is standing his ground. KP's going to be here to shield him free, get him away from the torrent. You're under tier 4 towers, TNC. Silence up Gabby, spirit him forward with a searing chain. They can finally bring down this Bristleback. But my God, is there nowhere safe for Gambit when TNC can just run at you like this and you still didn't even kill the Alchemist?
And you also get the 4 bounty runes that spawn Toby. And the tier 2 bottom, perhaps, as the next creep wave comes in with a catapult in tow.
1,050 GPM for the Alchemist.
He's doubled up anyone on Gambit, and second place is Gabby. That's where it gets scary. In the games that Gambit won against an Alk, they were the next 3 in net worth. This time, there's 2 huge tanky cores that are tough to take down. It's not just Armel in the base. Gabby's even further inside.
They are pushing all the side lanes, everything you've got. Alchemist has BTs and TP scrolls.
He just hit a heart.
Come back, he has the heart completed. And AC will be done in about 2 minutes. Express delivery. Alchemist, Lifestealer looks at him, it's like, I'm fairly certain I was 5th pick to try and counter this hero. I don't think he does that. Alchemist just runs the tier 1 tower, punch it once, sure, take the extra cash.
X-Mark,
Torrent, open wounds. Remember, he's still got BKB as... He's got a heart, he's got a BKB, what? He's got an Aegis Immortal, he has a team. And Sharshlow, Lifestealer just jumps in and then abandons that ship. Too many holes in this Kunker's boat.
I think they might be a little lost, Toby, and I don't blame them. I'm lost. I'm not sure what you're supposed to do. This Aegis is still up for another minute. Armel's going to take another tier 2, and you just keep going. Every hero of TNC is about to collapse on this top lane.
And what you need to do is add an extra ban to the first phase of Dota so you can just get rid of that Alchemist by default. They're coming in. The shields are on the tower. Alchemist will stand his ground, because there's no one that can stop him. Lifestealer is still not even inside the base. Dream is walking over at the moment. He still needs another 600 gold before he has that Desolator he's been working so hard to get. Maybe they can wait out the Aegis, the Immortal timing. I say maybe. Right now, Armel will potentially take your entire lane of racks, but the shields are causing a lot of problems. FNG, 4 points in the Frost Shield, just trying to keep the tower alive. Dream will mop up the creep wave. If they can keep the mid out, no, they can't even do that. There's no backdoor protection. Armel just cannot be stopped.
Is it Cave Troll, Toby? He's shrugging off all the damage, focused on the objective. Beat up what's in front of you.
I don't think they have Aragorn to kill that damn thing.
No, they don't.
Actually, it was Hobbits that did the real job.
No, it was Legolas, but you're close. Gambit, they're trying their best. Melee Rax falls. And, like, it just, you feel powerless. What does Gambit do? You don't have the tools to kill Alk.
Actually, if we go for the whole Lord of the Rings, right now, Alchemist, it still will only count as one if you do bring him down. So hard.
He's gonna have an AC in a minute and a half. And
what did we say?
Slotted.
We thought it was gonna be 2 minutes. He just needs the Hyperstone and the Plate Mail. Hang on, there's a creep wave up on top. Give me this. Dream just has to let it go.
I expect him. They're gonna kill this shrine. and Alkal just TP bottom.
Yep. The creep wave is already pushing in. He can jump on the back of that. Look to the tier 2 tower.
AC in 100 gold. So nope, just top wave. Then he'll get the AC, and then you maybe look to go bottom. Finish that last tier 2, and perhaps just go end the game. No Aegis, of course. So you've got a bit of a window for Gambit. You will be able to finish off that Deso on lifestealer. He's got it up now. But bottom lane, the AC's up, and here comes the TP bot.
Oh, they're right after Kunkka. Leap
oh, kill the creep, kill the creep.
And with the Yule Scepter up.
Al can't get here.
Now that he can't, but I don't think they really need him. Kunkka trying to throw the ship, Torrent, Boat, everything he's possibly got. Kunkka just permanently controlled, silenced. The Ember Spirit's bouncing around. Kunkka will finally be
Armel's
pulled out
the
underneath the tier 2 tower, but Armel, yep, inside the base. Sinister Gaze in, TP's arriving from Dream, and now Alchemist will be put to the test. They get the silence on him. If they have another stun that slows under the tier 4 towers, Searing Chain's back off cooldown. They just have to kill Armel, but oh wait, he's got BKB. Walks away, disengages, and now it's 171. Make it 431 HP, a second regeneration for an Alchemist.
Yep, even gets the cleave talent. All about the right click damage. And hey, let's kill this shrine, get a little more gold. Any items you guys need? Think about it, guys. Let's invest. It's time to go high ground real soon.
My god, 1,100 GPM. What is this?
It's Alkdota.
And he's TPing towards the top lane. No fear. The rest of his team is coming by. Oh, that courier cannot die. Like, it's flying out of Mystic Star for GPK. Looks like Dream's going to be put to the test. Trying to run out of here. The arrow's off target. Moving far enough away so this blink concoction stun's gonna work. The rage has already been used from Lifestealer and needs to actually jump inside. Maybe you get the double chain frost out, but now you see just how pitiful that damage will be. The only one you bring down low is a Baton. He's got borrowed time. Lich can't move away, slowed up too far. The arrow will hit the mark from Tim's. Archery champion and Armel, you know he's diving. Four hits to kill off Vampire, though he has to do it in five. The Searing Chains just hold TNC in place, but they cannot stop this Tide Gambit. TNC will just keep moving in and will claim more of these tier 3 towers and racks.
He exits them back to cancel the TP, but he's still got a little bit of the fountain regen. So Armel still with plenty of mana for a stun. Onto the mid racks. Shiva's utilized, but Gambit at this point, you're just throwing damage out onto heroes that don't give a damn. Everyone's full HP. Yule's into arrow. Nice FNG. He's going
to
die.
Yep. No way to bring him back up again. Dead for a long time, almost a minute. The tier 3 tower being chipped away. Gambit, they're still in there, so they think they have some level of a chance, but where is your damage gonna come? At the moment, you just can't battle that Alchemist attacking so fast. They're moving to the bottom lane, claim all threes. Everything you could possibly have, the ship, the torrent, Undying, that's someone you can kill. March will end up falling. Alchemist, concoction. He BKBs just in case he stuns himself. Dream now up towards the air with the Yule Scepter, looking for an extra stun combination, able to hit him perfectly. Lifestealer needs the extra life, needs to investigate out of here. He can't do it. He's down for the count. No buyback available. This looks like it's going to be the end as TNC go almost into the fountain. Kunkka has buyback available, but TNC, they just keep pushing. They have had such a flawless series throughout this entire tournament. This is when they were most tested by Gambit. And they just want to end it. They want to claim this victory.
Yep, give us some
They're
mana.
They're going to give it some respect. Ugh. They will back up. We're not done yet.
Two racks, 27K, 27 minutes. Armel is almost three times the net worth of any player on Gambit. Completely six-slotted. Has he got an Axe you want to buy? Maybe pick one up for the Abaddon. Get a Moon Shard, whatever he wants, really.
Whatever you want to do. I don't think TNC can go wrong, not unless they start tying their own shoelaces together. TNC look towards Roshan. The arrow instantly removing the flame guard with the Yule Scepter into the stun. Gabby will stay on him, but Ember Spirit has that defensive spirit all the way back at base. I think he just wanted to have a look at Rosh.
It is up.
But TNC don't need it.
They do not.
Like, Aegis and Cheese are both not utilized by the Alchemist. Yeah, the butterfly is going to be bought up as well. The courier is bringing out one of the parts. He'll go to the secret shop. So, yeah, 28-minute Alchemist with casual butterfly to backpack BTs. Jumps him, takes the tier 3 tower. The smoke are trying to attempt to wrap around. This should be the last fight for Gambit. We'll see how much power they've got. They focused on the Alchemist. They know he doesn't have an Aegis the Immortal, but Gabby puts himself between Gambit as well as the rest of TNC. Lifestealer try to get in the back lines to go after Timbs, but the Moonlight Shadow, they just hide under the cover of Invis. Their sentry wall is down everywhere, but Bristleback, he's being Sinister Gaze into the fountain, and then he just bashes FNG down under the cover of BKB, turns attention towards GPK. The arrow, such a long stun over on the Lifestealer. Concoction will follow it up. Torrent will not create anywhere near enough space. The Soulbind is out, but Kunkka can't run away from this. BKB Darmel, he will stand toe-to-toe with the entire Gambit team, but there's so much strength in this TNC lineup. They'll finish the objective phase gaming, they'll take the bottom racks, and they'll take the series, the grand final, the first team to ESL-1 to win from Southeast Asia, TNC.
A long road, a long series, a long day, but TNC pull it out. A great win for March and the rest of the squad. Don't think they've won a LAN, maybe ever. At least not in Europe, and this is huge for them. 3-2, they really grounded out.
That they definitely did. Props to Gambit, we still have to give them the recognition. They fought their way very hard into this grand final. They seem to be the only team as well that could challenge TNC.
And smiles on their faces too. It was a hell of a series. And at the end of the day, you got Alchemisted. Armel just absolutely unstoppable. You can't really do much but be a little sheepish about it. But TNC should be proud. Perfect items, perfect plays.
Alchemist ended almost at 1,200. It was 1,180 GPM at the end of that game. By far the raid boss, 906 for his Alchemist. It's been an insane performance by the entire TNC lineup. And it's just crazy to think that it's taken this long in ESL-1 history for a Southeast Asian team to rise to the point of being able to be crowned the champions of ESL-1. But it has happened here at ESL-1 Hamburg 2019. Your champions, TNC!